So America is the most powerful nation in the world. It's the most prosperous nation the world has ever seen, right? Yet our children rank very, very low in our educational accomplishments. Our freedom level is just below what you would think a communist countries would be in. Where do we rank in terms of poverty? Well, out of the 34 largest nations in the world, this is measured by the number of people who are in poverty in the country, or actually the lack of people who are in poverty. So the lower amount of people in poverty you are, the higher on the ranking you list. So like number one might only have 2% of its population in poverty. Number two might have 7% of its population in poverty. Well, we're the largest nation in the world, so we have to be number one, right? Nobody is more prosperous than us, right? No. Are we number two, Josh? No. Number three. We have to be number three, right? No. Well, we're in the top 10, right? Nope. Are we in the top 25? Josh, please, please, please tell me we're at least in the top 25 countries in terms of prosperity of its citizens. No. Okay, fine, but we have to be in the top 30, right? Nope. We're 31st. There are only three countries that have more percentage of their population in poverty than we do. And one of them is Mexico. To give you a comparison, we rank 31st. Yet the conversation today, as soon as you turn off this show and tune on the next one, the conversation is going to be about, well, it's the Federal Reserve. It's creation of jobs. We need to create jobs, jobs, jobs. It's the Republicans' fault. It's the Democrats' fault. You know whose fault it really is? Some of you have already guessed it. Ours. Yours, mine, and ours. What is the economy? Well, the economy is a term that I generally use as how the government does business. We need to realize that we are the economy. When you support something like Ranch Foods Direct, you are growing the economy. When you support shows that are on this network, you are growing the economy. You want to fix the problem? Then go to that mom and pop store today.
Yeah, but Josh, I don't have any money.
Well, the truth of the matter is, what money you have, you're going to spend. I understand not having a lot of money, but I also know that most Americans have a negative amount of money in their savings account. So the money you do get, you are going to spend. And as long as you're going to spend it on places that actually help the economy grow. Why? Because when mom and pop store on Main Street makes more money, your employer gets more money because mom and pop just bought something from your employer. So now they can add a shift to your schedule. Now you make more money. Now when you make more money, you have more money to take your kids to the movie theater. So the local 16-year-old kid who's selling tickets, now he has more money. Then he in turn, and you know, you see how this works? We grow the economy. The economy is not a finite system where there's only so much. There's a misconception that the economy is like a pie, and there's only so much pie to go around. That's not true, otherwise no economy could grow. The economy right now would be the same size as it was in the year 200.
Never thought of that.
Economies can grow infinitely. There's enough resources on this planet for everybody to be wealthy. Did you know that? And yeah, you know, we could get into the fact, well, if everybody's wealthy, then the cost of everything will go up. But yeah, I get that. But the bottom line is, there's enough resources to do it. We don't have a lack of economy. We have a lack of participation in the economy. How do we get participation in the economy? You start a business. Look, I love employees. I love people who are working hard. I love people who are doing what they need to do to provide for their family. But the truth of the matter is that an employee does not produce economy. Not in the same manner and by the same capacity that a business owner does.
Yeah, but Josh, you just told me that my employer adds a shift and then I make more money and then I can spend that at the movie theater and that helps.
It does help. Yeah, I'm not trying to downplay it. I'm not trying to criticize it. But where did you get your money? From your employer. From your employer. So it's actually your employer who is offering a product, good, or service to the community that is allowing that economy to grow, isn't it? And he's just allowing you to participate in it. And that's a benefit to you. You get a trickle-down effect. You know, Jimmy Hoffa Jr., he believes in trickle-down too. So don't get all,
oh, that's a conservative thing.
No, Jimmy Hoffa's all for it. That's what he said in a speech. Good jobs. Not just jobs, good jobs. And then those people can spend the money. Oh, see, now that's trickle-down, buddy. Waka waka. But that's what we need to do. That's what we need to start teaching. Folks, this is this vitally important. Every high school needs to be teaching entrepreneurship, period. We need to start telling our kids entrepreneurship is a very viable career path. When our kids come to us now and say, I want to start a business, what do we tell them? Get your head out of the clouds. Get your head out of the clouds. Go to college. Get good grades. Get a good job. No, I want to start up. No. Go to college. Get a good job. Why? Because we're under this impression that jobs create security. Oh, really? Really? And that's why we're ranked 31st? Really? That's why 22% of our children are in poverty? Really? That's why 1 in 6 adults are in poverty? Did it really create that security you thought it would create? Liar, liar, pants on fire. I was in a hotel once, checking in, and this guy, you know, he kind of recognized me, which is a growing phenomenon, and I kind of dig it, just to be honest. But anyway, he, you know, he's like, well, I don't know if I could start a business. I heard that some businesses fail. And I said, look, this is how this breaks down. Only 2% of the population who has jobs can take care of themselves at 65 years old. 2%. And this guy was stating the fact that 95% of all businesses fail. Well, what's the remainder then? 5%. So even in a worst case scenario, you just doubled your odds of success. Do you not know basic math? And then, you know, maybe 4 years ago, matter of fact, maybe even 18 months ago, we would have heard something like, yeah, but jobs offer security. You can work for a pension and medical and a pension. Did I mention the pension? Yeah, how'd that work out, genius? Or the government jobs. Yeah, the government jobs, they're great too, right? That's why states like Kansas are warning their retirees. States like California are warning their retirees, hey, I know you thought you'd be getting a pension for the next 20 years, but oops, we ran out of money. What? So that's the idea of a good job? Listen to me. Listen very carefully. With rare exception, there are very few jobs that you should want to have your children to have for life. I am not opposed to jobs. I'm not opposed to hiring people. But I don't want the people who I hire to have the highlight of their life to work for me. That doesn't create a dream and a vision in them. That doesn't create the motivation for them to go out and create something that adds to society. And there are rare exceptions, and that's awesome, and that's great, and they should be rewarded. If you're a doctor or a surgeon or a firefighter, or, you know, awesome, stay there, do your thing. Yay! But let's just face the facts here. There are 330 million people, and we're not all doctors and firefighters and, you know, like-minded calling jobs. Truth of the matter is, if I offered you $1 million to quit, you would quit before noon today. That means there's a disparity there, and we need to fix it. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back right after this. I don't care what the Federal Reserve does. If we're not in a position to fight back, we can't win. So what? So, you know, it's led by 5 to 7 elite families. So what? Can you buy billboard space to tell the world? Can you buy documentaries from Infowars.com to tell the world? You know, Alex Jones does some pretty interesting good work over there on his show. I don't agree with everything he says, but the guy's heart is definitely in the right place, and he puts out some phenomenal information and documentaries and all that sort of stuff. I would consider myself a fan. And he wants to grow that empire, and in order to do so, he's going to need money, right? So can you support him? Can you support this show? By goodness, you should be. You should be. Because I don't want to toot my own horn, but I have not heard another show like this on the entire planet. And it's not that we're competition for the other shows. We're not. They do their thing. We approach this from a purely different perspective. I have the honor of being listed as one of the top 100 business trainers on the planet Earth, and I'm the only one who addresses issues like this, and I'm the only one who has a radio show. And we wanted it that way. We wanted to take this perspective, this ability to take the information that great organizations are putting out there, and then let's add some strategy to it. Let's add some action to it. Let's actually get this thing done. You know, there's a report out today. We were going to cover it in the news, but I decided it's really not, you know, whatever. It is what it is. They were talking about Rick Perry's ability to raise money and how much money is going to be needed to spend on this election. And the front runner right now in the campaign fundraising is Mitt Romney. Now, I know a lot of listeners to this show, including some station owners that carry this show, are huge supporters of Ron Paul. Ron Paul has in his war chest at the last filing with the Federal Elections Commission a little over $4 million. Not too bad. I mean, we're early in this thing. It's still over a year away. So well done. That's good. How much does Mitt Romney have? $170 million raised by fundraising so far. Now, if you don't need to be good at math to notice a very huge gap there. $4 million, $170 million. Well, whose message is going to be louder? Who's going to be able to get more airtime? Who's going to be able to get more billboards? Who's going to be able to get more radio ads? Who's going to be able to fly more places? Well, the answer is obvious. So why do you need to start a business? Because there are good candidates out there who need you. There are good bills of legislation who don't have backers. We always complain, well, the money's behind it. The money's behind that law to prevent quality farming. Okay, did you put $1 million behind the good bill? Well, no. Oh, I see. And I'm not saying you need $1 million. That's not the point. And if you think this is about the amount, then you missed it. Go back to school and grow up. The point is, we need to get regular people like you and me, we need to get us back to business ownership or we are toast, baby. I don't care. I don't care if we know everything about the enemy. If we can't fight back, we're dead. Yeah, but Josh, we can do a lot of grassroots stuff. Yeah, you know how much money it takes to do this grassroots stuff? Go ask Alex. Grassroots is still green, man. We still need the green to get the grassroots. And here's the thing. It's just a drop in the bucket compared to what we need. The truth movement, the people who believe in freedom, we need billions in order to fight back. And that means to get a pool of billions, we need to make a lot of wealthy people. How do you create wealth? Through business. We've already covered how wealth can never be created through employment. It cannot happen. I don't care who your financial planner is. I don't care what mutual fund you're in. I don't care about the 401k or the Rule of 72. I don't care about any of that stuff. Because unless you're getting 10% interest a year on your savings and on your 401k, you made no progress. You actually went backwards. Matter of fact, at 10% interest, you still made zero. We need to get ahead of that inflationary curve, and the only way to do that is to start generating wealth. And in order to generate wealth, you need to own a business in some way, shape, or form or fashion. You can own a business part-time basis in addition to the job you're working. That'd be the smartest way to do it. You definitely need to get some quality business training, wink, wink. You know, people need us out there. People need to pick up the bill for lawyers to fight the good fight. You want to hear something that's really going to frost your cookie? A second grader got arrested for punching the vice principal at her school. Arrested. And what was she arrested for? Second degree assault. Are you serious? Arrested. Now, am I saying that she should be able to hit her principal? No, obviously not. She should be punished. But should she be arrested? No, absolutely not. Oh, and she's a girl. An 8-year-old girl got arrested for punching her 61-year-old vice principal in the chest and at 8:15 in the morning, causing pain. What? You're a 61-year-old grown man. An 8-year-old girl punched you and it caused pain enough to call the police? We should arrest you under false impersonation of a man. But yet, nope, she gets arrested. Arrested. Cops come. Handcuffs out. Click, click. I mean, good golly, and no exaggeration, we're lucky this little girl didn't get tased for being a violent threat to society. And how hard can an 8-year-old girl punch that actually causes pain? If we had the money flowing through this show, I would love to fly a lawyer down to this little girl and say, little girl, fear not. We're going to kick stupidity in the teeth this afternoon, and you don't have to pay a dime for it. This is ridiculous. We see this all the time. Folks, look, we could go on for hours and hours and hours about the stupid news out there. Farmers who are now in prison because they accidentally ran over the wrong kind of rat when they're in their tractor. Roadkill happened, and because it was the wrong kind of rat, the dude's now facing prison time. We need to send that guy some lawyers. We need to send some lawyers to the kid who handed out a flag on September 11th, and now he's in trouble at school because that's just inciting violence. What are you talking about? And we hear the information. We can listen to great radio shows all day long and hear all this great information about what's going on in the world. But unless somebody does something to empower us to do something about it, we're going to lose the battle. And I would rather be dumb and not see the bullet coming than to see the bullet coming and not being able to do anything about it. That's why this show is so vitally important. That's why the book, Quit Your Job or Die, is so vitally important. That is why we have guests on this show to offer you ideas, opportunities, suggestions into starting your own business. And that's why I'm the only host of my type who is actually willing to go out there and train businesses on how to succeed. Let me tell you something. You know how many people said that would be stupid to do? All of them. Josh, now that you're a talk show host, you really have to stop training businesses because that puts your name on the line. That makes, you know, we don't see Rush out there doing it. We don't see Glenn out there doing it. Well, first of all, they couldn't do it if they wanted to, but that's besides the point. The point is to take that step and actually offer training, offer suggestions, offer real life impact. And that is so rare that it's not even funny, and that's why they advised against me doing it. Josh, now that you're going to be a public name, you need to stay out of helping people on a private level. Forget that. Forget that. Why would I just want to settle for being a talking head? That does us no good, folks. And yes, I agree. If you have another favorite host and they're out at a political rally, join them because I want to do those too. But we have an opportunity here to do something that the world has never seen. And I hope you're a part of it because it's going to be huge. And make no mistake, I am humbled by the opportunity to talk to you on a daily basis. I am so proud of the station owners and the program managers who are smart enough to realize what they have their hands on here. And I am so happy that I get to do it all again tomorrow. And until tomorrow, may your path lead to heaven, and may freedom follow in your footsteps.